Project Soli is the secret star of the Google Pixel. How Soli radar protects, put you all into watch smart home equipment and lots more. Hey guys, this is CP from Imaginary Programmer, and today we are going to talk about Project Soli. If you are looking for a new weird thing to do with an smartphone, consider hands-free use. Google's upcoming Pixel 4 is going to throw hands-free twist to its front camera array. In addition to face recognition, it will sense motion and hand gesture. This technology, originally called Project Soli, uses radar to detect 3D movements in space, and that's addition to adding new face scanning infrared camera that's tech similar to Apple's iPhone X Face ID. Google Soli tech was FCC approved earlier this year and was accepted in the Pixel 4 before Google confirmed it. So what does this mean, and why is Google announcing all this news now? Google's upcoming October phone aims to pull off waves and air swipes that will silence calls, skip songs, and operate other shortcuts. But this could be about a lot more than just a phone. In fact, it could be a Google's attempt to at building new interface to its embedded computing ecosystem. As Pixel product manager Brandon Barbilo hints in Google's latest Pixel testing blog post, Soli is a part of Google Advanced Technology and Project Group, which also created the Smart Fabric Project Jackpot, Google's first phone-based AR tech, Tango, and the modular Project Ara, phone that never ended up happening. Even though the Pixel 4 has full new front-facing camera array that uses infrared dot project to scan face, just like the iPhone X, Soli's radar chip doesn't need a camera to do its work. In fact, Project Soli first debuted back in 2015 at one of the Google's I/O developer conference, when I got to see it in brief demo. Back then, it was using to control sound with your finger gesture in the air, no remote needed. You could technically use iPhone X front-facing true depth camera or Pixel 4 similarly infrared equipment camera to recognize hand gesture, but you had need two cameras to be on and looking. The advantage of Project Soli is that in theory it could be working at any time. And working without camera means it could work in device that could stay camera free and still allow motion control. This could mean that you wouldn't need to set camera in all your connected home tech. Google Soli page talk about how the radar tech in the Soli chip can work through fabric. On a phone, maybe it could work through pants. Apple ID already works in the dark, but Soli ability to work through certain materials could make it candid to embedded in walls, dashboard, or other objects. It seems like a perfect tech to put in light switch or door panel. I think about Soli and I think about Google Home. If I could combine voice and gesture, maybe I could invoke command without saying "Hey Google," or I could lower lights by rising and lowering my hand, or do that with volume. Google already demonstrated Soli working with smart speakers back in 2016. In fact, that was the first killer use case for Soli. Now that's it emerging in a phone, putting it in speaker or even a nest. Seems like an obvious move. Google's other demo of Soli back in 2016 developer event involved controlling a watch hands-free with fine-tuned gesture above the watch display. Maybe that seems silly when you already have watch display to touch, but imagine a Pixel watch that uses Soli for simply gesture control that works near the watch. You could use it for answering calls, silencing, launching a workout, or who knows that. I'm already uncertain about using voice when I'm driving, but it's better to operate touchscreen. Soli's wide range of hand gestures seems like they could be a useful way to control things without looking. I say this is a lot of hesitation, since we don't know enough about driving safety while using something like Soli. But it seems like it could make it possible to operate volume controls or accept new route suggestions. Air gestures sound like the future, and I love future. But even Sims attempt hands-free control system failed before. The Microsoft Kinetic, which allowed me to totally control a game console with my hands from my sofa, never ended up being a substitute for just picking up a game control or TV remote. The LG G8 ThinQ phone added a camera-based air gesture to operate volume and music playback by hovering over the phone, but pulling off the move felt like performing a complicated magic trick. Samsung had gesture control in phones and TVs for 4 years, but do you even remember them? For air gesture to work, they will need to feel precise and always responsive. Any failure and I will feel like I am falling, And if they happen, even a few times, I will go back to voice or search and whatever else works better. What can I remember of the Soli demo I saw a long time ago was that it worked. While the Pixel 4 is going to have a lot of new tech on board when hits in October, Project Soli seems like the test drive of a platform that could end up spreading out beyond phones. I like Project Soli. Well, what do you think? Tell us in the comment section below. Also, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it and share it with your friends. Lastly, subscribe to our channel for more amazing videos. That's me signing off. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next one.